Hey guys, I've been on vacation for almost 1 week, so I've been down south, and today it's the 1st of November, and I woke up, couldn't believe the luck we're having today with the weather. Although down at the coast it's not really all that sunny, but this morning, which is awesome, with about 10 degrees above zero Celsius, which is super rare for this time of year up here in the north. So what better to do on a day like this than to make a last dash out to the Balesudden Nature Reserve and back home. So it's going to be something like a half marathon on trail and dirt roads, and I'm taking you guys with me.
Chasing behind me, getting closer every day. Block out the things that hold me back. Help keep you away. Oh, 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 oh.
Okay, so we made it out to the point. I don't know if you can hear me because it's really windy, but basically you can't run any further east than this where I live. So this is the absolute coastline, you know, at Balesudden. And you can actually see the Skuleskogen National Park, you know, where the Höga Kusten Trail Marathon is. That is the ridge line at the horizon over there. So you have the race over there. So basically I can't stay here, it's too windy. If you look at the sea, you can see all the wind being channeled through this little strait here. So there's a lot of wind coming over this little point. So I'm gonna try to make it back into the forest. When they are arranging the swim run events, they make it so that the swimmers have to swim over from these islands over here across the strait, and then they have to climb up to about 90 meters in altitude using ladders all the way to get up here and then run this trail down. That is kind of crazy. You know, let me show you how steep it is. And maybe that is not something you want to do in a wetsuit. Look at this. This is kind of steep. It's probably hard to see, but you have something like a 70 meters drop off here. So to make it up here by using ladders and stuff, wearing only a wetsuit and a pair of running shoes, that is absolutely insane. But of course they do it in summer. But this summer during the swim run event, it was 7 degrees in the ocean. And on land or in the air, it was something between 6 to 9 centigrades above zero. And we had torrential rain just pouring down on us the whole day. We were actually going out here to cheer on the swimmers, but it was so windy and the weather was so bad that they decided to turn around the swimmers and have them swimming back to the coast once more. It turned out that making it across this strait, swimming a little bit more than 1 kilometer in rough sea, was a bit too much. And you know, the race manager probably thought something like, okay, this is the second time we have this event over here, and if somebody drowns or die, I will probably not be making another race next year. So yeah, that was kind of I don't blame him, you know, for turning around the swimmers. But yeah, this area is crazy. It was ravaged by fire a few years ago when a lightning struck the point, so every tree basically just burnt down, as you can see here. This place looks like a mixture between Mars and Mordor. Time to refill. And this is one of the best spots to do it, really. The hikers have been so kind, or the community has been so kind as to put up a log here and you stick it into the ground. So where there was a natural little stream here before, there is now a tap, so where you can fill up on water. And that's great, and I'll definitely need it for the last 10k of today's run, because they will be a lot faster. Now the 10k that I've done in the nature reserve of Balesudden are naturally very slow, because we have a lot of climbing and a lot of tricky parts that you might have seen. And yeah, the good parts looks like this. Fairly wide trail with roots only, so you really need to think about where you put your feet and really mind your steps. But now, as always, I'm going uphill. So in my mind, that means rest and to hike. Because really, running up these slopes are, it's tough, you know. But it doesn't really give you much. You know, you can really make up for that on the flat and the downhill, so it's better to hike up and to save some energy. So we made it out of the nature reserve, and now we're on Logger's Road, it seems, where they drive out forestry machines to clear cuts and stuff. So this is what we're going to run on for 7 kilometers until we hit the high coast trail again. Here's the moose trail right there, so there are definitely moose around. And looking at the watch, I'm making the same progress where I'm as fast in the nature reserve running as I am on a flat street when I'm walking. So 10k in 2 hours sounds legit. This is actually quite pretty. Cool stuff. So this logging road would probably be easier to run on than the natural reserve trail, but considering that I had to run and hike uphill for 2.5 kilometers until I reached the top that you see behind me, I would say that this logging road is pretty tough as well. But you get nice views like that one. And for the first time today, in earnest, we get to run in the sun. And it's 1:45 in the afternoon, and look at where the sun is. It's pretty low. So yeah, it's definitely coming on to winter now. Give it another month and it's going to be more or less dark all day round. Now we do get sun during the day, but only for a few hours, something like 3 to 4 hours every day. So that's not much. Sun goes up at around 10 o'clock in the morning and then down somewhere around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So yeah, you have to make the most of the days we have left with sunshine, because after that I'll be working when the sun is up. So I'll only have the chance to be out in the sun during weekends. And of course it will be winter as well by that time. Okay, so we have roughly something like 7 kilometers to run to get home. And it is a bit windy and cold today, I have to say. Okay, so we've run roughly 10 miles now in something like 2 hours and 15 minutes. And for the last 7k I've been on a dirt road. Now, something like 5 kilometers back, the road turned into this, a gravel heavy duty logging road, and I'm guessing that the only vehicles that use this road logging vehicles, so that's why they have this really, they fill the area with really rough, large stones, and they're really sharp and stuff. So I've been running downhill on that for 5k now, and my feet are really starting to feel it because I'm not used to running on this stuff, even though I have a rock plate in the shoes. It's hard, you know. And now it started raining as well, so I am tempted to run down to the main road and then call for my girlfriend to come pick me up, because I think that 18, 19 kilometers is probably enough for one day. I was aiming for the half marathon, but I don't think so, not on this kind of ground layer. Doesn't really, I don't feel like it today. And I've been running enough this weekend. This weekend was, by the way, supposed to be my off week, where I went down to pay a visit to my relatives and just take it easy, maybe run a 5k or something like that. And it ends up with me running 2.5k on Monday, 11k on Thursday, and now something like 19 today. So yeah, I think the idea of a rest week has just vanished, I guess. Alright, so there was this area was closed. Okay, good to know. Until next time. Well, that didn't turn out the way I wanted it to. I called home, found out that the car had been lent out, so I have to walk slash run the way home. So that's what I'm gonna do. So it seems like I'm getting my half marathon anyway. So, with that said, I'm walking now because I'm on a slope, but once the road flattens out, I'll start running again. So it's been a knackering run, really, really technical, but all in all good. And sun is setting behind me at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So thank you for watching. See you guys around.